Hey everyone, have you ever looked at a t-shirt design and wanted to know what font they're using? Well, Creative Market just released this font finder that you can use to help you with that. So I'm going to show you how to use it in this video. We're going to take it for a test drive. You can use it absolutely free. I'll put a link in the description. So let's get into Creative Market right now and font finder. All right, so here I am on Creative Market, creativemarket.com. And if you've been here before, you know they have lots of fonts. If you scroll over this fonts, you can see they have a ton of them. And this is where you find Font Finder. You can click on this or click in the link in my description. I'll put it there as well. You can click on Font Finder. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna look at t-shirts. Now this will work with any image. So if you wanna take a snapshot of a t-shirt you find at the mall or go to Etsy or Amazon, I'm gonna go to Amazon and I'm gonna go here. And this is my Pretty Merch Pro account, my research tab where you can see all the different top selling designs. And you may want to scroll down here and see like, what is this font? Let's take a look at this right here. This is kind of an unusual font. It looks really cool. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a screen grab on my Mac. So what I'm going to hit is Command-Shift-4, and that gives me this kind of this right here. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to click and drag, and then you can see I'm only selecting that part of it. So that bruh. If you don't like that, you can do it again, but let's do this and let's see if that works. So I'm going to bring that into my font finder. So I'd saved it to my desktop. I'm just going to drag that into my font finder here. You should select images and it's trying to recognize all the different things on here. It didn't recognize the B. That's weird. So I'm just going to do that. This is R and this is a U. And it's probably getting confused with all of this right here, or the contrast isn't as good. So I might have to come back. Let's see if it does it though. So it has two letters here that it recognized. I'm gonna hit match it. And it has some good ones. So Drawly, that didn't really match, but this Dream one looked pretty good. It's not an exact match, and it's only making finding the fonts that are on Creative Market. So if we come in here, like this one, for example, you can see you can buy it from Creative Market and look at it. And one nice thing too is sometimes customers bought some other ones that are the same, and you can look at it that way, or you can come in and do it again. So let's see if we can get some other ones. I'm going to clear this out. One of the ones that was interesting that I saw was this one, this motorboat. So let's see here. I'm gonna do the same thing. In fact, I'm gonna take the whole thing this time. Command-Shift-4. See, I got that again. And I'm just gonna do this part and click it. That saved it to my desktop as well. So let's try this again. Fonts, Font Finder. Whoops, I went too fast. Font and Font Finder. And then drag that in here and see what happens. Whoa. That did a little bit different, but let's see if it, yeah. Your image, yeah, look at that. So it took the whole image and this time it gave me some, this is pretty close. I don't know if this is the right one, but it looked pretty good. I like this. So you can see sometimes it's, even though it's not exactly the same, they give you some pretty good fonts. So let's go back here. What else? Yeah, this is a pretty nice one. So they got a ton of fonts and you can come in here and this is a good way to find new fonts as well. So even though they don't match, you may be like, wow, this one's really cool. I want to get this one and save this one. So this one has a lot more on it, but I think it did a pretty good job at matching this, that M and the O. Yeah, I think this is pretty much it. That motorboat, see the T looks the same and so on. So great job on that one. Let's try another one. I'm gonna scroll down here. Now you can do it with any one of these, but I saw another one that I kinda wanna get the text on. Let's see if I can find that here. This one I think is an interesting one. It's a distressed one. And let's see if we can get just, I'm gonna do Command-Shift-4 again. Get those and just get the text here, all right? And just drop it into Font Finder, fonts, Font Finder. Now it's kind of hit and miss because they don't have all the fonts, but you'll find some nice font. So yeah, so it took it, and you can see this one doesn't have that distressed look, but this one has that the lines through it, just like this. Jesus, yeah. So this one's really close, and I would click on here, and maybe sometimes they do have a distressed, not this one doesn't, but you could put a distressed texture on top of it and still come up with the same thing. So yeah, you can see here are some other ones that are similar. If we click in here, Flake Alley, you know, maybe this one has a distress version. No, it doesn't, but it has that same kind of style, right? And you can come back again. I'm going back and looking at some of the other ones. Okay, so this one right here is very popular. It's a very popular style. It was very popular back when 100 Days of School was there. So I'm gonna do something, Command-Shift-4, and we'll see what happens. Because there's two fonts in here, will it pick up both? And I don't know if it will. Let's see. Back to Font Finder. It might get confused because we're trying two different fonts. Yeah, so you can see it's trying to see which one of these fonts is the one you want. So first I'm just gonna do the solid one. So this is a 1, that's also a 1, that's a 0. That's a 0, and this is an S, capital S. And I think those are all the ones that are clear, so I'm gonna hit match it. And you can see that that's the Magic Retro, Hello Winter, and so on. But what about the Of School? So if we came back here and did my Command-Shift-4 and just did Of School, I'll show you what happens sometimes. Is that because it's all connected and it looks like one big letter, it's not gonna recognize it. So let's do this and see, it's having a hard time trying to figure out what letter is what. So one trick that you could do here is bring this into Photo P and kind of separate these and knock out these if you really wanna take that extra step. So I'm gonna do that for you so you can see what happens. All right, so I'm here in Photo P. I'm gonna bring this in here, just drop it, Of School. And I'm gonna make it a little bigger so you can see. First thing first, I'm gonna erase some of this that we don't need, the other letters. And I can make my brush smaller by going like that. All right, and maybe just a little bigger. Just getting it close in here so that I can get the letter, just the letters that we want, just the black, right? Okay, so that by itself isn't enough. We're gonna have to do a couple more steps. So the next one is I'm gonna separate the letters just a little bit. And just by doing this right here, see that? I'm separating where it connects. I'm just gonna kind of chop it. Just using the erase brush again here. Just so that the Font Finder can see, like, these are separate letters, even though they connect in the font, I can see that they're separate letters. And then I'm gonna flatten it. I'll move my face over here so you can see what I'm doing. I'm gonna change the levels on it and bring in the white and pump up the black like that. That should be good. And then last step, I'm just going to add a white background. So I'm going to add another layer here, move it in the back, use this right here and make sure that's filled with white, not black. There you go. All right. So that should work. Crossing fingers that it should work. You can kind of see each individual one, and I'm gonna export this as a PNG, save, and let's see what this does in Font Finder. All right, so I'm back in Font Finder. I'm gonna drag this in, the one that we did on Photo P, and you can see right there, and now it doesn't have an issue with it. It kind of knows. Let's see which one is the right one here. Has a bunch of options here, some handwritten script, some nice ones right here, and so on. So that's one way that you can do to help you or help Font Finder find you the right font. Now, it's not going to work for every single one because, again, it's just looking for the fonts that they have on Creative Market, but Creative Market has thousands and thousands of fonts. So the likelihood of it getting a close match, if not the exact match, is pretty high. So you can come in here and it will give you some really good fonts too. So I found a lot of good fonts just in this video that I'm like, I think I need to get that one for myself. So have fun with this. This is Font Finder. Again, I'll put the link in the description, but it just goes to fonts, or hover over fonts, go to Font Finder, and you can use it for free. And yeah, it identifies the font. You can see how fast it was, and it will give you more instructions here, but I thought I'd show you. It's pretty new. I think it came out last week, and it's pretty amazing. Got some really good fonts on Creative Market. So have fun with this, and hopefully find the right fonts for your t-shirt designs. So there you go, that was Font Finder by Creative Market. Let me know in the comments if this is something that you would use. And if you wanna learn how to do that 100 days of school design that I just showed in here, I have a tutorial on how to do it. Now you know what fonts to use. You can do this for any niche out there, St. Patrick's Day, Easter, or whatever comes next. Try it out. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.